Hello and welcome to a new episode of YouTuber Art. This time I want to make some fan art of YouTuber Drew Dunnell. I actually had the idea for this fan art 6 months ago, but a lot of things prevented me from actually realizing it. As always, the first thing we have to do is to find a picture of Drew Dunnell that we can use as a reference point. Sometimes it is not easy to find a good picture of a YouTuber, but this time it was really easy because he has a great profile picture or avatar or whatever you want to call it, where we don't have to edit too much. So what I did is I put the picture into GIMP and I took out all the colors, so we just have the black outlines. Now all we have to do is to print out the picture. And yeah, let's look what materials we are going to use for the colors. Okay, now we are going to pick the materials we are going to use. We have 4 different colors we need. We need something yellowish for the hair. We need something skin colored for, of course, the skin. We need something black for the outlines, and we need something white for the teeth and the eyes. We all know Drew Dunnell has paintbrush hair. So what else could I use other than actual paintbrush hair to make his hair?
Even if you have a fuckboy haircut like me, and you kind of look like a paintbrush.
This is not a joke, I got a lot of paintbrushes to make his hair. Also, we know that Drew Dunnell is a real soy boy. So we are going to make his skin out of soybeans. For the eyes and the teeth, I'm going to use some weird white powder that I found in a bag. It was just laying in the alleyway. I don't know what it was doing there, but yeah, I think Drew would appreciate it.
Wait, what were we talking about?
Okay, the last thing I'm going to need is something black for the outlines. I thought I might use licorice for that, but I don't really know if Drew likes licorice. So I asked him on Patreon and he said yes. So yeah, I bought a lot of licorice. And I don't really like licorice, so I'm not know what I'm going to do with it afterwards. I printed out the outlines on paper, so now all we have to do is to fill it in with the materials that we have chosen. So it's time-lapse time! We'll be right back. is it. I think the final result turned out pretty good. I hope you liked the video. This is actually the first time that I'm standing in front of the camera. Normally I'm just doing the time-lapse thing, but I thought it would be more interesting if I would tell a bit more about what I'm doing and just speak a bit about the projects in general. I would really appreciate some feedback. Did you like that I'm standing in front of the camera, that I'm talking about the project, or did you find it better when I was just doing it and just showing the time-lapse? For me personally, it feels a bit weird standing in front of the camera because I normally don't do that kind of stuff. But if you actually like it, I might do it more often in the future. Yeah, let me know in the comments. I hope you all have a nice day and we see us in the next video. We'll be right back.